Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Splatoon. Last time, we finished up the Inkling Boy amiibo missions, and in this episode, we are going to be switching off and using the Inkling Squid amiibo. We're going to start off with the green one, and it's going to look a little interesting when he pops in here. Oh, he's just kind of floating there. Why, hello there, Freddo. Thank you for kindly summoning me here. I can see you're just itching for some way to test your skills. Well, I've been thinking up some challenges that might float your boat. What do you say? Think you're up to the task? By the by, I hear you've been making quite a splash over in Octo Valley. In fact, I saw you at it, wearing outlandish gear and fighting odd creatures. I think that proves you have what it takes to attempt my challenges. What do you have to lose? I have some nice rewards for you if you win. Why is this guy British? Anyway, it's more Inkling? It's more... missions, but this one's gonna be very different. Let's get started here with Octo Trooper Hideout. Catch that Zapfish. Look at this. Kraken, and it's a time attack. Yeah, what's the Kraken, you may be asking? The Kraken is a special weapon that you can use in the online mode, but as you'll see, when we go into squid form, we become the Kraken, which is pretty incredible. We have a regular, like, splatter shot looking thing. I don't actually know what weapon this is. I'm assuming it's a splatter shot. But it's the Kraken. We get an attack when we jump, which it didn't quite do right there. We get an attack when we jump, which I'll try to do right here. Okay. All right. It's not working. We can literally swim anywhere we want. We're faster than this guy. Sort of. There we go. We can swim anywhere we want. We don't have to worry about inking the ground before we swim. And it's just incredible. The Kraken is truly, truly a force to be reckoned with. And that's why these missions are time attacks, because this isn't that hard. Because it's really not that hard to stay alive, I guess. It's pretty damn easy to just kill everything when you're the Kraken. So these episodes are probably going to be some of the shortest ones from mission mode. Or from, if you want to call it mission mode, I don't know, from the amiibo missions. It's going to be very short. Because this Kraken kind of breaks everything. As for the bosses, I imagine it's going to be more of the same. It's just... it's going to be like playing through them in the regular mode with the... you know, just with the regular splatter shot. It's just we have the option of Krakening up if we so decide. The Kraken, as far as I can tell as well, is completely invincible. It can't get shot. I'm going to go ahead and go over to this guy and just let him shoot at us. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. We're invincible when we're in Kraken form, so... yeah, this is fun. I wish that the amiibo missions were a bit more like this, where it uses, like, a special weapon, or... you know, they give you some kind of sub-weapon or whatever that you have to utilize more, and not just be, like, missions, but with a different type of main weapon. This is a really unique way of doing it, and I was really looking forward to playing as a Kraken, if I'm being honest with you. And I kind of tried to keep it a secret this whole time, because it is such a unique set of missions, you know? It really is. Alright, I believe our thing that we're looking for is right here. Just the ability to swim wherever you want without having to ink is, like, my favorite part about this. There we go. Open up the key thing. And I believe we can also just jump into this as the Kraken. Yep, we can. And open it up. Oh my god. Yeah, these missions are gonna be, pretty short. Pretty short, I gotta say. Nice! I also just love that the Inkling Squid is just floating there. Lair of the Octoballs! Let's go, we only have 3 minutes to complete this one. Is it gonna be super fast? Probably. Honestly, I think the boss fights might be the longest parts of these episodes, because look at this, we can literally just skip it all. Hit that, climb the wall, climb this wall. Look at this! Tell me this Kraken's not broken. He just skipped that entire thing. Alright, let's actually shoot something with our gun. How does that sound? Not that that thing really put up that much of a challenge. It almost drifts around corners. It looks really neat. You die. There we go. I guess to make this a little bit more of a challenge for myself, I should try and kill some things. That's probably a good idea. Maybe. I don't know, I like speeding through this. I like speeding through as the crack boy. Like this. I guess I'll leave that octoball alive. You do get a tiny boost from jumping as well. Now, normally when you use a weapon that has the Kraken as its special weapon when you're playing in an online match, it only lasts a little bit of time. It doesn't last forever like this is doing. You get it for, like, maybe 10 seconds, if that. It might even be less than that, but yeah, you don't just get to zoom around with it at all times like you do right here. But I will admit, getting to do that here is a ton of fun. A ton of fun. And you know what? Because we're the Kraken and we can swim literally everywhere, we don't even need to worry about going up to the little special section with the cannon. We can just skip all of this. Because look, there's our sapfish! Okay. I kind of forgot I'm invincible. I could have just stayed in Kraken form. Look at that. Jump into him and kill him. Oh! Well, I guess we're going back down. Sure, I'll kill the octoballs. He's stuck in the jump pad. Okay. You gonna die now? There we go. Yeah, look at this. Just skip. Don't even care about the little cleany boy. Just skip the entire thing. Easy peasy. So yeah, we're gonna be getting probably some less than 10 minute episodes out of these missions, but that's not too bad, I suppose. It's just fun to speed through them. It really is. Your skills are impressive. Thank you. Rise of the Octocopters, Leap to Victory. Let's go. 3 minutes for this one as well. Let's see. The fact that this is mostly octocopters means we're probably not going to be able to reach them, which means I'm probably just going to skip past them, because why bother trying to attack something when you can just skip it? All right, you know what? Never mind. You're challenging me. He was chasing after me. I had to do it. I just had to, you know? There was no other option. Look at this. It's so stylish, too, doing flips and everything while it's jumping. I love the Kraken. And I think too many people loved the Kraken in this game because it didn't come back for Splatoon 2. It's not there. It's just not in any weapon set. Which is unfortunate, but for Splatoon 3, I believe that they've announced that every single weapon is coming back for that game from the first two games. Does that mean that the Kraken's gonna make a comeback in Splatoon 3? That would be cool. I would very much like that. Because it's honestly one of my favorite special weapons. If you can even call it a weapon, it's just you turn into a Kraken squid. which is a weird thing to think of in and of itself. Is a Kraken technically a squid? Like the Kraken from, say, Pirates of the Caribbean? Is that a squid? Is it just a giant squid? I don't know what it is. You got me thinking now. If anybody knows, let me know in the comments. What the heck? What is a Kraken classified as? Big squid? Big octopus? Or is it its own thing? Kraken. You know? I haven't said Kraken enough in this video, clearly. I forget that word is even a word sometimes, you know? Until right now, where I've used it 50 times in 2 minutes. Okay, I honestly... Oh my god, we are at the final checkpoint. I was about to say I thought we were at the, Zapfish. We basically are. It's right up there. Do your bombs even affect me in Kraken form? I know that regular shots don't, but it doesn't. You fool! Whoa, how did you think you were gonna do anything to me? Oh my god. There we go. Another one down. I honestly forgot just how speedy these missions were. Not that I'm complaining, it's fun. It's real fun. Another little bit of money right there. We've gotten a lot of money from these missions. And now, squish, squash, smash the mighty Octo Stomp. Oh, I forgot we do get more gear for this. We got this weird helmet looking thing. Which I'll go ahead and put on, alongside the rest of our samurai gear, I guess. Now this guy, I'm curious. I mean, I don't think we can climb up his side until he's jumped over. I mean, that would make sense because his tentacle appears on his back. But we're not going to have to spray his sides at all. We're just going to be able to climb up him, no issue. So this shouldn't be too bad. Also, we're fast. I didn't really mention that about the Kraken, but it's a fast thing. And boom. Honestly, the thing that takes the most time is just spraying him. That's what takes the most time in this fight. Well, I am curious. If we jump into his tentacle, does it do more? I don't know. Let's find out. Look at this. He can't even keep up remotely. Okay, and let's jump into that. Okay, it works. It's probably better to shoot, but it does work. It definitely does work. And one more time. Oh no, you're electrified. Whatever will I do? You should make your sides water. I can't deal with water. For some reason, Inkling's I mean, they evolved from squids, but can't deal with being in water. It's very strange. And you're done. I ducked down a little bit too quick there. Look at that. Look at our trail. We barely went anywhere. You compare these runs of levels to, like, the ones with the chargers, it's just night and day. It's night and day how fast this is. Although, keep in mind, your timer does still go down once you defeat the boss. So you gotta be a little bit careful there. There we go. We're done with the first episode in like 10 minutes. It's gonna be even less than that because I was doing a lot of explaining in this one. We got the power mask. I would like to put that on in place of my samurai helmet. Oh, no, hang on. There we go. It looks so weird. I guess here's the info since I don't believe I showed it. Cool. And there's the power mask. Alright, neat. We have a weird mask on our heads now. Look at this thing. Wait till you see the full set, by the way. The full set is ridiculous. Also, since I never showed it, I guess I'll show you the name of that minigame we unlocked. It's Squid Racer. I can't really show you anything on the gamepad, but it was Squid Racer. Anyway, folks, with that is going to go ahead and do it for this very short episode of Splatoon. Next time, sorry, bird, I didn't mean to scare you off. Next time, we'll be heading back over here, talking to our squid buddy, probably switching him out for the orange one. Is there an orange one? Whatever the other colored squid one is. Squid amiibo, that is. And taking on the second set of his missions. Also, I just noticed this guy's hair is like... Does it always point up like that? I feel like that's pointing up more than Inkling boy hair normally does, right? Yeah, that's very, very odd. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. I'm you! Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.